The Speedo is probably the most hated device by any Model A driver. This tells you're going too fast, this tells you your loop job is due, and if you have eyes in your head, then you may have been able to spot that there is no more numbers on the mile counter. And what you don't know is that this thing doesn't work properly either, because whenever you start the car, this thing starts howling like a hound dog. Typical signs for dry grease and a worn out bearing, so we're going to take it apart, relube it, repair it, and put some new decals onto the odometer. So the good news is that I got everything apart without, you know, breaking the brittle casting here or anything. The bad news is that this shaft here is marred. And the way I see these traces is it marred when they took this end piece and pounded it on here, because it has the same marks. And that caused a risen edge here. And upon driving this thing out of here, I've broached some nice oil passageways into this hole here. Aside from a little superficial scoring, luckily no harm was done, so we can now move on to the decals. I went to the lathe and chucked this thing up and spun it slowly to a point where all numbers are triggered. Can you see this one here is moving, and now it's catching, and then all of them move. That's the point at which I want to set the decals, because now these are all zero, and the last one doesn't matter because it doesn't have to trigger anything else. And then I went ahead and installed it in the casting, put that into the housing, and scratched me a mark. I don't know if you can see that, but I've scratched it where the zeros will have to be readable in the counter window. And that's where I want to align the new ones with. Now in here is a little bit of alcohol. And now I'm going to try and clean everything up as good as possible. And remove the remnants of the old decals here as well. So that's as far as I'm going to take it. I fear I will take the black numbering off here if I go any further. And like any good car salesman, I'm just going to slap the roof of it, call it patina, and say I love it. Plus, you're not looking at your Speedo while you're going zero. You're probably more worried about your car when it shows this. So, yeah. Warm water, not hot water, you don't want to burn your fingers. And we're going to let this soak for a second here. And when it's done, we're going to add the mile counter and then hopefully slide everything on in one go. And then you may have noticed, if you own a Model A, that when you freshly cracked the 10,000 mile mark, it's more like a diagonal. That's because the play isn't all out of there. So what I've done is I've rotated all of these upwards, take the play out of it, they all get evenly distributed, just so you don't have the numbers dancing about. This is interesting, now that the zeros and the nines are aligned. That can't be right. Have I done anything wrong?
Right, you know you're about to witness a train wreck of different snippets of footage when it's voiceover time. What I did know is that there was two types of Speedos for the 2829s and for the 3031s, but what I didn't know is that there were actually three. Two were made by Waltham, one was made by Stuart Warner, and I had the wrong number. Long story short, I got the correct numbers. These ones are stick-on, not water decals, a lot easier to apply, a lot harder to correct once they're on there. All that's needed to do after carefully applying them is to slit in between the wheels with a sharp razor blade so that the individual numbers are separated from each other.
I mean, come on. For a first try, that's not bad. It's time to reassemble everything. So the assembly spins nicely and freely, with barely any noticeable play in either direction. And when you take a peek inside the bore here, you can see that the tool did actually throw the edge over a little. Now the dust caps that go in here normally will fall right out when I put them in here, and my hope is with this nail, which just barely doesn't fit in here, I will be able to open up the end just enough to make it a snug fit. I don't want it so tight that nobody can get them out again, but you know, just so they won't fall out while you're driving along the road. That would be nice. Yeah, you see? Now it won't fall out. I wonder how much of this waffling I'm going to keep in. And how much are going to be music. So I quickly went online, found out what speeds my lathe is capable to run at, found out what speeds equal what RPM on this speedometer, and then I've put an old speedo cable into the chuck of the machine, then put this in an upright position. Now we're expecting 38 RPM. Yeah, here we go. Thirty-six and a half. Look, I mean, we're 1.5 miles off. Am I going to tamper with this? No, sirree. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you, well, not completely refurbish a Speedo, but get it going again and getting it to show numbers. Thank you very much for watching. Hope it was watchable. And see you guys next time. Bye-bye.